What's up, everybody? Back at day three of FormNext, the world's largest additive manufacturing and 3D printing conference. Today, I had planned to take you all through another floor of Building 12, but I realized that, like a lot of the show, it is very much industrial manufacturing, metal 3D printing, and I imagine that most of you are not too interested in metal 3D printing. So today, I'm going to touch on some of that stuff, show you some of the borders between where prosumer ends and industrial begins, and then we'll go back to some of the consumer stuff and go a little bit deeper and show you all some of the other cool things that are being released at FormNext. Hope you all enjoy these videos. If you do, make sure to like and subscribe for more 3D printing content. And now let's dive in and see what you missed at FormNext. So we are here at Fiber 3 Material, and they make composites with glass fibers and carbon fibers. They have all different kinds of materials that can be printed on a regular printer from a Prusa Mark III and upwards. You can see some of their incredible materials, and it's obviously hard to capture on video, but the rigidity of these materials is insane. If a normal plastic printed in a 3D printer this thin would have some give and some flex, I can't even get this to budge a millimeter. So really, really cool. Their products range around 120 euros per kilo. And if you need incredibly, incredibly strong parts that can withstand a ton of force and also higher heat, check them out. We are now at the booth of Markforged, another name many of you will be familiar with, and they have all different kinds of displays for 3D printing metal, which is not uncommon at the show, but they have some smaller machines, it seems like. Just some really interesting displays of 3D printed metal. Incredible. This does appear to be fiber reinforced printed parts.
Hi, I'm Daniel from Markforged. Markforged is basically founded to make functional parts for manufacturing applications. So all of our 3D printers are based around FFF or FDM technology. On the composite side, what we do is we take a normal FDM printer and we lay long strands of carbon fiber inside of parts. In this case, fiberglass, but these continuous fibers yield basically aluminum strength parts or parts that are capable of replacing aluminum application. On the metal side, we have an FDM metal system that requires, basically has three machines, and what it does is essentially prints bound metal powder that you then debind and sinter. And that's a really accessible metal technology from the ground up. It costs much less than other metal technologies and enables you to essentially bring metal printing in-house for a much more approachable price point and in terms of a much more approachable kind of entry point from labor and education, all that kind of stuff. So that's really all it is about Markforged.
Here we have seven different rolls, which are color just for demonstration purposes, but feeding seven different nozzles so that you're able to print faster by feeding more material, and it is dynamically switching each of the different materials into a seven nozzle setup. All right, we are now at the booth of Flashforge, a company that I don't know a lot about, but they have some very interesting stuff in the consumer grade. They have their Adventurer 4 consumer 3D printer, as well as their Photo 13.3, which looks to be an SLA printer. Do not open during printing, but it is not printing. Large build area, very exciting, and just amazing fit and finish of these products. Everything is sheet metal, no plastic parts really. Very, very impressive, and kind of goes with just my general theme of my last few videos, that the bar has definitely been raised, and a lot of these manufacturers are coming out with amazing printers that look like, you know, ready polished products with acrylic and sheet metal and touch screens. And we've moved on from the MK4 with printed parts that you have to assemble yourself. As well, they have some of their amazing professional grade printers. Have a look at this Guider 3 Plus. Phenomenal, huge build volume, touchscreen. I mean, this looks like it's a professionally made product by HP or Epson or Canon. Core XY Kinematics. And check out this lovely little guy. This seems to be an IDEX Guider 3. Very small build volume, but you know, it's IDEX, independent dual extrusion. Really, really cool. And this seems to be analogous to what we saw the other day in my previous video from Snapmaker with their IDEX solution. Here we also have some more professional grade products from Flashforge, including their Creator 4. And this, what looks to be an Ultimaker killer, the Creator 3 Pro, really polished looking product. Very interesting. And new from Flashforge, they now have a proper storage solution for your filament, a filament dryer made of all sheet metal and aluminum. Wow. Really cool. This looks like a professional grade product, the fit, finish, and feel. Finally, from Flashforge, we have this tiny, cute little guy, little mini 3D printer. And I'm not actually sure the model of this, but this is a small little 3D printer that could sit on your desktop. By popular request, here is the AnkerMake M5. Many of you have asked to see. Just look how fast this is printing. They claim up to 5 times faster printing. This is at the 3D Prima booth. Really impressive. And this does have a replaceable tool head. Touch screen. Really nice. And just look at the fit and finish. You've got these LEDs. Again, making some of the other printers in the industry look like artifacts, historical artifacts. Very impressive printer. Look at the quality of the prints. I have to admit, I kind of want one. And by the way, built-in AI camera monitoring. You can see the built-in AI camera right there. And many other features. Easy assembly, auto time lapses, auto bed leveling, hub connecting multiple devices. Very impressive 3D printer. By the way, if you're wondering what this guy costs with all the AI and smart features, 800 euros, so about $800. That is less than the Prusa Mark III with significantly more features. And it is also available with a 6-in-1 color-changing nozzle, which will allow you, with only a prime tower, to change 6 colors with this one device. Very impressive. Apparently, pricing is going to increase pretty soon. Here we have the new, all new, brand new Ender-5 S1. Incredible printing speed and quality, around 250, 200, I believe. Look at the quality of these prints. Just remarkable. However, unlike the AnkerMake M5, which is the same price point, if not a little bit more, maybe $100 or euros more, this machine has a more difficult setup and also has no camera, no AI failure detection, no smart connectivity, and a much smaller, more simple touchscreen. So even Creality is really getting a run for their money from these new entrants into the market, like Snapmaker and Anker, and of course Bamboo. So it's interesting to see that even those who are challengers in the industry are being challenged themselves to innovate more. All right, friends, we are at Rosa Filaments, one of the only, if not the only, manufacturer making true color cycle filament in Europe, all produced in Europe to an extremely high standard. What's unique about Rosa is they have perfected their own process for color change, where they can actually tell you exactly how many meters in between the colors, so you can vary the infill, and if you want a specific number of color changes in your print, you can vary it, because you know, for example, that the colors change and go through a full cycle every 170 meters. Really cool, made in Europe, right in Poland. Check them out. If you need ultra high precision for printing out electronics connectors, check out the NematX printer. It has a 250 kilo slab of granite designed for printing ultra, ultra tiny connectors with precision that is just not possible using other technologies. Pretty cool, and look how fast. So if you need to print hundreds of thousands of connectors with ultra, ultra high precision, NematX is your go-to. Check out the speed of the Snapmaker J1, printing two benches in 12 minutes. Incredible. Incredible.
Hey, we're Slice Engineering. I'm Dan. I'm the CEO and co-founder. We're really excited to be here and to be showing off some of our new printhead models. We've been launching pretty consistently about one to two printheads every few months. And we're focused on getting specific applications for specific machines that are basically drop-in ready. So sort of plug-and-play setups, about a 15-minute installation period, very quick and easy. And in most cases, we're boosting flow rate by 20%+ and decreasing heat creep by 60%+. So a massive increase in performance. And if you're looking for performance or reliability increases in your machine, we're the folks to talk to.
We are now at the booth of Azurefilm, which is a really cool story. Family business based in Slovenia. They not only make their own filament, but they also make their own spools, and they even make and design their own filament extrusion machine. They have a group of companies that the family business owns that even makes the displays that they use in their booth. Now, what's unique about them, 100% made in Europe, and when I say 100%, I mean even the spool is made by them in Slovenia. And in addition to offering the same 1 kilo size that many manufacturers offer, they make 5 kilos as well as 10 kilo spools. Again, 100% made in Europe, but also available in Canada, Australia, and through their network of retailers. But check out this amazing extrusion machine made and designed 100% by Azurefilm. Really cool. Check them out as well. All right. Ready? We're recording. All right. Here we go. We're going to scan my foot. And let's go over to the TV screen and see. That's my foot. I recognize it. All right, everybody, that's all for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, hit the like button, subscribe, and make sure to check out all our other videos. We have tons of amazing 3D printing content, both in the past, present, and future. Thanks for watching, and take care.